Now, we are going to learn next topic, that is estimation of numbers. See, what is meant by estimation of numbers? Sometimes we need the exact quantity, correct? Or exact number, sometimes we need. For example, suppose mother asks us to bring 2 kg of potato. She needs 2 kg of potato. Means there we know what is the exact number of potatoes we, means quantity of potatoes we have to bring from the market. And in second examples here, Pooja is expecting nearly 150 people for her wedding. How many people? 150 people for her wedding. So, is it necessary, or can we say that 150 means 150 people only will come in the wedding? No, she is expecting. Maybe 148 will come, 140 will come, or 155 will come, 160 will come. Means we cannot tell exact number of people who can attend the wedding. Or for example, now if we want to construct the house, okay, we want to build a new house, then how many bricks will required for to construct the house? That exact number can we say that no, to construct my house 10,000 bricks are required, 1 lakh bricks are required? Can we say the exact number of bricks? No. So near about, suppose say 20,000 bricks are required, 25,000, 50,000, near about. So whatever these, whatever exact value we don't know, and whatever we have predict, that is called as the estimation, estimated value. Okay. In the estimation of numbers only, see here, next is rounding of numbers. So what is meant by rounding of numbers? First, let us understand the meaning of rounding of numbers. Now see, if the cost, we want to go to purchase books, and suppose the cost of books is rupees 1628. What is the cost? 1628. Then when we go out from our house, or while taking money from the house, exact, do we take the exact money 1628? No, we may take 1700 also, or 1630 also, like that. Got it? So means we did not take that exact 1628 or 18 or whatever. We round, means we take 3-4 rupees extra, means that whatever, and we make the round figure of that. See, this 1628, it is odd figure, and 1630, this is called as a means we converted into the nearest 10, 28. So we convert into 3 tens, that is 30. So such it is called as a rounding of numbers. Suppose the cost of one frock is rupees 567, okay? But, and if your friend asks you, what is the cost? You easily say, it is 600, near about 600. Then sometimes we are using such numbers, and that is called as a rounding of numbers, okay? So, we can round off a number to the nearest 10, nearest 100 also, nearest 1000 place, nearest 10,000 place, or nearest lakhs place, and etc. Means, suppose nearest 10 means CL, 123. Okay, how to, now where is the 10th place? Here, correct? So how to make round of it? 130. Okay, means for, but it will not become 130 because there are certain rules that I will explain in next part. But here we have to round off the numbers. We can round off the numbers nearest 10 place, nearest 100 place, nearest 1000 place, nearest 10,000 place, nearest lakh place, and etc. Followed? Rules of rounding numbers. See, now we will learn. First one, replace all the digits after the one being rounded off by zero. Okay, what is the meaning of this? Suppose the number is 1360. Okay, 1360 means 1360, and we want to round off to the place of 100. Okay, up till 100. Then where is 100? See, 0, 10, and 1s, 10s, and 100. So this place we have to do round off. Correct. So what they have told, replace all the digits after the one being rounded off by zero. Means after 100, whatever places are there, that we have to write replace by 0, 0. Means though here 6 is there, we don't have to write 6. We have to write 0, 0, because we are going to round off the digit at hundreds place. Now see, next. If the digit after the one being rounded off is less than 5, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, then we do not change the digit to be rounded off. Okay. See, for it means what? Now see, what I said, I want to round off the digit at hundreds place. Correct. So when I can change it after, now see, after 3, which digit is there? 6. And here what is the second rule? If there are, after this, there are digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Out of this, if any digits are there, then we cannot change the next number. Okay. If here 3 would have been there, now if here 3 would have been there, the hundreds place number would have not changed. It would have remained 3 only. Means what is the round of 1330? It is 1300. Why? Because see, after, now this place we want to round off, correct, 100. After 100, 3 is there. After hundreds place, next digit is 3, which is smaller than 5. If the digits are smaller than 5, then this number, it doesn't change, it remains as it is. And as per the first rule, the number or the place which we have to round it off, after that whatever digits are there, that it becomes 0. We have to write 0. See, replace all the digits after the one being rounded off by 0. These are the two rules. Now what is the third rule? See here, the third rule is, see, if the digit after the one being rounded off is greater than 5, that is 6, 7, 8 or 9. Out of this, if any digit is there after the one being rounded off, then we increase the digit, then we increase the digit to be rounded off by 1. This is the third rule. Okay. See, if the digit after the one being rounded off is greater than 5, that is, suppose here 6 would have been there and hundreds place digit we have to round off. Now, see, look at the next digit. It is greater than 5. Correct? So, while rounding off this number, it will increase by 1. Means 3 plus 1. What we have to do? We have to round it off by 1. Increase the digit to be rounded off by 1. Means we have to add 1 in that. So, what will be the round of this number? 1, 4. And here, what we have to write? 0, 0. Got it? in these are the three rules. And fourth rule is leave the rest of digits unchanged. Now this we have to change. As 6 was there, this we have to increase by 1. And whatever other digits are there, that we have to keep as it is. They will remain unchanged. This is the last rule of rounded off a number. Now we will solve one example. See here, round off 5682 to nearest 100. Now this we will solve by the rules one by one. Okay. Now see here. 5682. We have to round off to the nearest 100. Okay. So as per the first rule, what we have to do after 100, whatever places are there, that we have to make 0. Okay. These places we have to make 0. Followed? Then, what is the second rule? As 6 is greater than 5, it will increase by 1. Increase by 1. Okay? And this, it remains unchanged. Because 100 place only we have to round off. So see, as per the first rule, whatever digits are after 100th place, that we have to write, make 0. Then, and now this place we have to round off. So we have to see which number is after that. If it is greater than 5, we have to increase 1 here. But if the next digit is less than 5, then it will remain as it is. But here see, 8 is there, which is greater than 5. So increase this place by 1, and remaining places it remain unchanged. Okay, so what will be the answer then? 5 will remain same, 6 increase by 1, 6 plus 1 is 7, and other these places make 0. So what is the round of this number? The round of this number is 5700. This is the answer. Followed? Second example we will see now. See, round off this number to nearest lakh. Now what is this number? 29,62,381. And which, up till what place we have to round off? Lakh place. Okay, this place we have to round off the number. So first we will round off, first we will write the number as it is. Okay. As per the first rule, the place after lakh, see here, after lakh which place is there? This. So, the place after lakh, whatever is there, there we have to write 0. Okay, these. Means from 10,000 place onward, we have to write, instead of these digits, we have to write 0. So, how to write digit after digit after 10,000 place digit after 10,000 place make each one as 0. Okay, means these digits will become 0. Now, next, which place we have to round off? Lakh place. This is lakh place. So, while rounding off, what we have to do? Which digit is there after 9? 6. Now, is it greater than 5 or smaller than 5? It is greater than 5. Correct? Means 9 plus 1. We have to add 1 in that. Then it will become 10. Correct? And other places remain as it is. Means that 10 we will add here. 2 plus 1, it will become 3. Follow? So here what we have to write? Increase it by 1. Okay. Therefore, what will be the numbers here? 9 plus 1, 10. So here 0 will come. And here 2 plus 1, 3. Correct? And other places 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. Okay? Here. Instead of these places, what we have to write? 0. And 9, we have to increase by 1. It will become 10. So that's 0. And 1 will carry here. 2 plus 1, 3. So round off this number is this. Next, we will learn about estimating sum or difference. When we have to do addition of two numbers or we have to take difference, that is subtraction. That time, how to estimate them? So for that, rules are there. Again, first is observe the smaller number. For addition, two numbers are there. So from or while subtracting also two numbers we get. So from that two numbers, we have to see which is the smaller number. Then second rule, round off each number to the highest place value of the smaller number. Now see, suppose this is one number, okay, and this is another number. Then what we have to do? See here, these two numbers I have to add. Now which is the smallest number in this? This is the first rule. First we have to observe the smallest number. Then second, round off each number to the highest place value of the smaller number. Now what is the highest place value of the smaller number? Here see, 100. See, 1s, 10s and 100. This is the highest place value. And so we have to round off these places. Now here how to round off? See here, after 2, what is there? 3. So 3 is smaller than 5. So this it will remain 2 only. 100 place it will remain 2 only. It will not increase by 1. Why? Because here 3 is there, which is less than 5. And as per the rule, first rule, other digits we have to write 0. They will appear as 0. So what is the round of 230? That it is 200. And now here also, in both the numbers, we have to round off each number to the highest place value of the smaller number. Now, as highest place value of smaller number is 100, here also we have to round off till 100's place. So, see here, as per the rule, first rule, these places will remain, become 0 and 2. After 2, 3 is there, which is again less than 5. So, it will remain unchanged. And remaining we have to write as it is. So what is the round of this number? 1238 is 1200. 230 is 200. So we have to add it. We have to add or subtract, whatever, as per the question. But understood this second rule, first and second rule. Now third, then we have to add or subtract the rounded numbers as per the question. Yes, this is the third rule. Okay. In this way, by using these three rules, we can estimate sum or difference of the given numbers. After estimating sum or difference of the numbers and understanding the rules for estimating sum or difference, next is estimating product. Okay. For that also rules are there. First rule, round off each of the factor to its greatest place. And second, multiply the rounded off numbers. For example, see here, round off each of the factor means, for example, suppose the numbers are 96 and we have to multiply 96 and we can take 487. Okay. So what is the rule? Round off each of the factor to its greatest place. Now what is here? See here. What is the greatest place here? 100. What is the greatest place here? 10s. And we have to round off it. So here other place what will come? 0, 0. Now this place will increase by 1 or decrease or will remain same. How we will come to know? by looking at this digit. Now this digit is greater than 5, so 4 will increase by 1, it will become 5. And now here see, as per the first rule, we have to round off each of the factor to its greatest place. Here greatest place is tens. So as per the rule, first digit will become 0. And now see, we have to round off this greatest place. So we either 9 will remain as it is or it will increase by 1. It is depend on this number. Now see, this number is greater than 5. So 9 will become 10. Followed? Then what we have to do? Then we have to multiply. 100 5s are 500. And these two zeros. So this is the estimated product of 96 into 487. In product, what we have to do? We have to round off each of the factor to its greatest place. Whatever greatest place is there, that we have to round off. And then whatever number will get, that multiply. Okay. Next is estimating quotient. Okay. Now for that also rules are there. First one, first round off the divisor to its greatest place. And second, round off the dividend to the nearest multiple of divisor of step 1. Then divide to get the quotient. Students, first of all, you should know what is mean by divisor, what is mean by dividend. These terms you should understand. You should know it in advance. See here, for example, if I'll give you this 3255 means 3255 divided by 48. Okay. How to read this number? 3255 divided by 48. Now, in both these numbers, 48 is called as divisor, and the number to which we have to divide is called as dividend. Okay. So what is the first rule? The first round of the divisor to its greatest place. Now here this is the divisor. And what is the greatest place of this divisor? The greatest place is tens place. That is, at tens place 4 is there. So we have to round off this. Now according to the first rule, this place will become 0. Here we have to write 0. And now this we have to round off. So 4, see here, after 4, 8 is there, which is greater than 5. So in 4 we have to add 1. 4 plus 1, it will become 5. So what is the round off number of 48? It is 50. Okay. Now what is the second rule? Round off the dividend. This is the dividend. To the nearest multiple of divisor. Now, here the divisor is 50. Okay. So, in 50's table, which number is close to this dividend? That we have to find out. Okay. Now, see 50. If I multiply 50 by 6, I will get the number. Or if I multiply it by 60, I will get, say, 3000. Okay. Then, now 3000, it is not that much close. So, I will multiply it by, again by other number. That now, multiplying 50 with 60 gave answer as 3000. But 3000 is also not that much close to this. So, what we will do? We will multiply it by... By 60, we got answer 3000. So, by 65, we will multiply. Let us see what is the answer. What number will come? 5 into 0, 0. 5 5s are 25. Now, we will multiply by tens place. So, units place compulsory 0 we have to write. Now, 6 into 0, 0. And 6 5s are 30. And then add this. 0, 5, 2, 3. Now, see. 3250, which is close to this number. Got it? So, according to the second rule, round off the dividend round of the dividend to the nearest multiple of divisor. Divisor is 50 and the nearest multiple of 50 is this, 3250. Then divide to get the quotient. So see here, 3250, we will divide. What answer we will get? See here, 50, 3250. We can divide it vertically. 56 is 300. Then take this zero down and 55 is 250. So what is the estimated answer? Estimated quotient is 65.